बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर।
स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल रिवाइज चैप्टर नंबर 21, यूज ऑफ कैपिटल लेटर्स। इट्स ऑन पेज नंबर 83 ऑफ योर ग्रामर ट्री, बुक 4।
स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन पेज नंबर 83, यूज ऑफ कैपिटल लेटर्स। द लेटर्स ऑफ द अल्फाबेट कैन बी रिटन बाय यूजिंग स्मॉल और कैपिटल लेटर्स। कैपिटल लेटर्स आर यूज्ड इन डिफरेंट वेज एंड फॉर डिफरेंट रीजंस। गिवन बिलो आर सम यूजेस ऑफ कैपिटल लेटर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई टोल्ड यू, व्हेन वी राइट अ सेंटेंस और एनी पैराग्राफ, it contains of different words, that words consist of capital or small letters. Now we will discuss some uses of capital letters. Number one, you know that proper nouns, that is the name of particular persons, places, buildings, etc., start with capital letters. Students, all of you know about proper nouns. Proper noun is the name of a particular person, places or buildings, etc. Students, all proper nouns start with capital letters. Here you can see the examples: Akbar, London, George, Rome, Sami. These all are proper nouns. So remember that when you write any proper noun, it always start with a capital letter. Okay? Now come to the next use. A surname is also spelled with an opening capital letter. Abraham Lincoln, Nelson Mandela. Students, when you write your name, you always start your name and your surname with capital letter. Here you can see the example: Abraham Lincoln, Nelson Mandela. Students, here name and surname both are started with the capital letter. Okay. Number three, if a name consists of more than one word, each word begins with a capital letter, unless it is a preposition. Students, if a name of a place or any other proper noun that consists of more than one word, it starts with a capital letter. For example, Atlantic Ocean, West Indies, Gulf of Mexico, Suez Canal, Cape of Good Hope, Arabian Sea. All these are proper nouns and they are consist of more than one word. So they will start with capital letter. Okay? Let's move towards next uses. Number four, names of religions also begin with capital letters. Students, when you write the name of any religion, it always starts with capital letter. For example, Islam, Buddhism, Christianity, Hinduism, Jainism. These all are the name of religions and they are started with a capital letter. So remember that when you write the name of any religion, it always starts with a capital letter. Now come to the fifth use. The first letter of an adjective formed from a proper name is a capital. Students, those adjectives that formed from a proper noun always start with a capital letter. For example, Chinese. It is an adjective and it's formed from a proper noun, China. So it start with a capital letter. Okay? Pakistani. It's also an adjective and it is formed from a proper noun, Pakistan, so it starts with a capital letter. Here you can see the more examples: British, it is formed from Britain; French, it is formed from France; West Indian, it is formed from West Indies. So this type of adjectives always start with a capital letter. Number six, you already know that the first letter of the names of days of the week and months of the year are capitals. Students, all of you know that first letter of the name of days and months of year begin with capital letter. Here you can see the examples. Monday, Friday, Sunday, Wednesday, January, March, October, December. But the first letters of the names of the seasons are usually small letters. Students, please remember that the first letter of the names of seasons are usually small letters. So, be careful when you write the name of the season. It always starts with a small letter. Here you can see all the names of seasons. They are not started with the capital letter. Initial letters of titles that are a part of compound name are capitals. Students, first letter of title of the compound names are always start with capital letter. Here you can see the examples. Sir Donald Bradman, Her Majesty the Queen, His Excellency the Governor of Sindh. Note that capitals are not used for the and of, that is for articles the and prepositions of. Students, here I would like to clear you one thing. Capital letters are not used with the article the or prepositions like of. Students, you can see in the examples, Her Majesty the Queen, His Excellency the Governor of Sindh. In these examples, the is not written with capital letter. But note down one more thing, that capitals are used for the first letters of prepositions like through and conjunctions like because, as they contain more than four letters. It means those conjunctions or prepositions that contains more than four letters, they start with a capital letter. Now come to the 8th point. When we spell the names or titles of books, poems, stories, etc., we can use capitals in a number of ways. Students, when we spell the name of books, poems, stories, we can use capitals in many ways. For example, we can use all capitals. We can write all letters in capital letters. Here you can see the example, The Adventure of Tom Sawyer. Here you can see all the letters are written in large capital. Now come to the B point, large and small capitals. Students, we can use large and small capitals. In this way, we write all the letters in capital letter, but first letter is large capital and the rest of the letters of each word are written in small capitals. Students, let's see the third point. Students, we can also write the first letter of each word in capital except preposition, conjunctions and articles. This one is the most common method used for title of books, stories, poems, paragraphs, etc. For example, Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves, but The Adventure of Tom Sawyer, Stopping by Words on a Snowy Evening, On His Blindness. Students, in all these examples, you can see first letter of each word is capital and rest of the letters are small. Number 9, capitals are used to begin the names of historical periods and events. Students, capital letters are also used to begin the names of historical periods and events. For example, Bronze Age, Stone Age, Middle Ages, First World War. In these examples, you can see the first letter of each word is capital. Number 10, the first letter of every sentence is a capital. The first letter after a full stop is also a capital. Students, when we start new sentence, it always starts with a capital letter. And when we write a paragraph or essay, the first letter after a full stop is also a capital. For example, a dog was sitting under the table. Students, here you can see sentence is started with a capital letter. So we were a little scared to enter the room. Then Rayan's mother came in and asked us to sit down. Students, note that after each full stop, the word is started with a capital letter. Let's move towards next use. The first letter after a question mark is also usually a capital. Students, when we write a paragraph or essay, we use capital letter after question mark. It means after question mark, when we start a sentence, it will be started with a capital letter. For example, how are you? Have you seen a doctor yet? Who rang the bell? I cannot see anybody anywhere. Students, in these examples, you can see capital letter is used after question mark. Okay? Number 12, usually the first letter of every line of a poem is a capital, though it might not be the first letter of a sentence. Students, have you noticed when you read a poem of your book, the first letter of every line is capital, though it might not be the first letter of a sentence. Students, for examples, you can see poems of your Oxford Reading Circle book 4. Students, these are the uses of capital letter. Now move towards exercise.
Students, here is the home task. Do sentence number 6 to 10 of exercise of this chapter from page number 85 in your English language copy. Students, this is the end of today's lecture. Watch all the slides thoroughly. First, make title page and index, then do exercise from sentence number 6 to 10 in your English language copy. Inshallah, we will revise another chapter in the next session. Thank you. Till then, take care of yourself and your family. Allah Hafiz.